Our brain is a material entity, a physical entity, a part of our physical body. Our past memories are stored up in our brain. Our thinking is generated by those past memories. Memories can be called frozen energy, while thinking can be called moving energy. According to scientists, both the matter and the energy are the same. Albert Einstein has said, energy and matter are two sides of the same coin. Energy can be turned into matter. Matter can be turned into energy. Scientists have proved matter stores up energy. Thinking is moving matter, as I said earlier, and thinking is based, as I said earlier, on the past memories stored up in our brain in a frozen condition. Memories stored up in our brain can be called frozen energy of the brain. And thinking can be called the moving energy of the brain. That means our thoughts are material. Our thinking is a material of process, material activity. Though we call thinking or thoughts mental, they are really physical. We just use words to differentiate between mental energy and physical energy. But energy is the same. Not only energy, as I said earlier, even matter is the same. Therefore, thinking is a material process. Thoughts are material. Enlightenment means going beyond the thought process, thinking process, going beyond the matter, beyond the material energy. Behind the material energy lies the spiritual energy, the spiritual energy of the universe, the spiritual energy of the mind. Scientists call that energy to be dark energy because it is not an active energy like the material energy in motion. The energy, the spiritual energy behind the thinking mind or below the thinking mind is non-moving, motionless energy. The energy in matter is moving energy, because although it lies frozen in the matter, it can be turned into a moving process. Even light is moving energy. Moving energy means moving matter. Light waves are made of electrons. Electrons can be called matter. They are material. Similarly, even our thought waves are material. Enlightenment means going beyond this material world of thoughts. Going beyond both the mind and the body. Both the mind and the body are entities within the unlimited space of the universe, the boundless and timeless space that is the background of our mind and the body. Enlightenment means going back from our mind and body into that background and becoming one with it, becoming one with the boundless, timeless universe, or the timeless, boundless space. But that space is not in motion. It's a motionless state. But even empty space, according to scientists, is full of energy. The energy of the empty space is called dark energy by the scientists. Therefore, although enlightenment is called the dawn of light, it is the dawn of that dark energy. In fact, it is the light of the dark energy. Behind our thinking mind and sensing mind, thinking ceases at the first stage of enlightenment. That is why, after enlightenment, the Buddha uttered his paean of joy, saying, "Visankara gatam citta." Thinking ceased at my enlightenment, at the enlightenment. Cessation of thinking. Thinking ceases at the enlightenment because the causes of thinking cease at the enlightenment. Thinking is caused by our likes, dislikes, and ignorance of the reality of things. Because we think of things that we like, dislike, or ignorant of. Enlightenment means the extinction of attachment, resentment, and ignorance, called raga, dosa, moha in the Buddha's language. That means realizing a mind free of liking, disliking, and ignorance, attachment. Free of ignorance means full of sensitivity, perfectly sensitive mind. That means mind that is aware of everything, awareness. Awareness by insight, not by the sight of the eye or the mind, but an inner sight, vision of everything. That is why the Buddha is called the omniscient, seeing everything, sabbajñu, one who sees everything. Enlightenment means reaching the state. That is why it is said in the Karanime Sutra, Dittincha Anupagamma Silava Dasanena Sampanno. Ditti means opinions, ideas, thoughts, mental forms. Going beyond thoughts means going beyond the memories, the cause that generates thoughts. Going beyond likes, dislikes, ignorance that create thoughts. That means realizing an empty mind, emptiness. That is why the nirvana realized by enlightenment is called sunyato. Sunyato means emptiness. Empty, that means the mind empty of its content, is nirvana. Though the mind is empty of its content, it is in touch with the boundless and timeless space or the universe. That is why an enlightened one is called sabbajñu, sensitive to everything, aware of everything. That is the perfect awareness. Dasanena sampanno, seeing things. When you see things means there is no need for thinking. You see it, you see things, and when you see things, there is no need for thinking of things. When you know the reality of things, the mind is free of likes and dislikes and ignorance of the reality of things. And that mind may be called beyond the material, the physical body, and beyond the mental body, beyond the mental world. But that is the boundless and endless reality that one can reach by enlightenment. It is timeless means it is not born. It is not manifested. It is the eternal truth, the ultimate truth, the absolute truth. And that truth cannot be known by the mind. That is why nirvana is called atakkavachara. Cannot be grasped by the mind. Because there is no knower, neither knower nor knowing, nor the object of knowing. Non-duality. The knower, the things known, and the knowing becoming one and the same. That is the final state of enlightenment. That one really reaches not at the enlightenment but at the final passing away after the enlightenment, with the final passing away of this world, whereby one goes beyond both the mind and the body. That is the absolute state of final truth that one realizes after enlightenment.